Hello, and I'm here with a video response for the two vloggers more. 10 childhood nostalgic questions. Let's pull up the answers. I don't know what my script is for this. Well, I've lost my script, so I'm going to have to do this from the top of my head. Question one. What decade were you a kid during? And do you think they were better than the current day? Young little lad during the 80s. I was 12 years old in 89, so I was a teenager during the early 90s. And I'll say yes. Now we'll just go to question two. What was your favourite toys as a kid? Transformers, when you knew that was coming up. Lego. Anybody remember Playmobil? Didn't really play with my car now. And then of course still got my superstar football figures. Hey, no reason to throw them out. John Barnes, LucasAid Sport, and the great rap from New Order's World in Motion. I do know all the words to that rap and the Anfield rap. I have that on record. And Brian Robson, of course, Captain Marvel. Three favourite TV shows as a kid. Most have been mentioned, so let's say Jason and the World Warriors, Biker Grove, Grange Hill. Who remembers Woof? Pop, the one that used to spit on the screen on Channel 4 on a Sunday afternoon and write his name on the screen. That did exist. Other things like, yeah, Mind the Boom, that was all mentioned. Manimal was also mentioned. I'll just throw Just Good Friends, Only Fools and Horses in there for good measure. The Young Ones, Naked Video, Bottom, there you go, One Foot in the Grave. There's a few shows. And that brings us to number four. Top three favourite childhood movies. I could say Flash Gordon, Life of Brian, Monty Python, Back to the Future, Terminator 2. I'd even chuck The Bodyguard in there. Ghost. See, a quite collective range of movies I do watch. If I missed any there. Boys in the Hood, Do the Right Thing. I could go on and on, but there's some of my favourite movies. I don't know if I did a top three. Tell us about a birthday party experience. I wasn't much for parties for my birthdays. I really couldn't care less. All I remember about parties, I loved playing musical chairs. I would battle between that. I never understood why, when I was sat next to anybody playing pass the parcel, why they were trying to snatch it out of me. I never liked it anyway. Pass the parcel, I would get it, just lob it to the next person. I couldn't care less. Well, that was very interesting, wasn't it? Number six, a favourite board game and video game as a kid. With video games, I had the Commodore 64. Favourite games included One Man and His Droid, Master Runic, Cheap Games for a Pound, and Soccer Boss, any type of football management game. No, other consoles were the Amstrad CPC, where I loved Quick Snack, Oh Mummy, had a Master System, really loved Alex the Kid, Outrun we had on that, R-Type. Got the Super Nintendo in 93, Street Fighter 2. You know, a lot of my consoles, as I've always said, I used to play them in, say, Mega Drive would be in Argus with the Atari ST. Also had a Mega Drive in Rumbelows. Then my Nintendo was in John Menzies. Loved playing Castlevania. You know, Shinobi, Streets of Rage, Golden Axe on the Mega Games, Road Rash, Sonic the Hedgehog 1 and 2, you know, playing Super Mario World. I remember the SNES was first in Argus, then they had a Super Nintendo in Boots. They had games like F1 Exhaust Heat, F-Zero, so some quality games there. Favourite board games? four. I could win on that. Buckaroo, I could actually stop the donkey from flying everywhere. Hungry Hippo, so you can make the board flip over. I like playing chess and checkers. I think the only board game or board game that did my nut and I even rebought it and still couldn't do it to this day was Screwball Scramble. Can't do it, couldn't finish it. But hey ho, try my best. Annoying game that I actually, when it was actually my game, I could actually smash it up. Tell us about a childhood holiday vacation you fondly remember. 5 years old, went to my mama's country, Switzerland, Uttliberg. Lovely place, lovely place. As we were going up the Alps, I puked in the car. You know, it's the altitude, you know. Not used to the climate in Switzerland. It's a lot different in England. You know, and I couldn't sort of handle it, so in the back of the car, posh car. Dublin, you know, many trips to Ireland, always looked forward to them in the summers. And of course, Republic of Ireland qualified for Italia 90, lucky me. My Uncle Joe is the president of the Referees Association of Ireland, so tickets went hard to get a hold of. VIB treatment, got all the way to the quarterfinals. I wasn't actually allowed to go until we played Egypt. My dad said there'd be too much trouble, so we couldn't go and watch England. So Egypt, Holland, Romania, Genoa was beautiful, lovely place. And we got to, I mean, the penalty shootout, Paddy Bonner made that incredible save, David O'Leary scored. I mean, the atmosphere in the Genoa Stadium was incredible. It was definitely all Irish. So mate, we got the quarter. So I next got the quarterfinals of that tournament out actually winning the game. Then we went to Roma, the Vatican, because you know, coming from my uncle Tony, who sadly passed away this year, was a Catholic. I remember my dad holding my hands, just make sure I didn't touch anything. Didn't really shake the Pope's hand or anything, it was more for my Uncle Tony. But that was one hell of a trip. Shame Island went out on the Saturday. Scarlacci, what a tournament he had. 6 goals and then faded away into obscurity. Got my words out there. Amazing, amazing vacation or holiday. And that wasn't scripted, as I said, I lost the script. What was something you collected as a kid? Story time. Well, we just did the story. And first of all, we have Football 88, my first ever football album with Clive Allen, who was the top scorer the previous season. Who's the Man United player? Alberston or someone no one plays, no one cares about. Finally composed it up. I've done a video on this years back. I said I completed this in 2009. It was a Charlton plane. I can't even remember who it was. I remember rushing down to the post office. One stick without the click down the post office. Now the story goes today that a lot of parents are complaining there are too many football collections. You know, back in our day, we didn't have many football collections. Are you kidding me? We had plenty. The Mirror 88 album, Britain's top sticker album, and it's free. I think the Daily Mirror there are making a bit of a wild claim there. I completed it last year through utter. Well, I found the sticks for the whole lot, £13 the lot. Not much I'm going to say about this album. It, if anybody remembers this, it's two shinies for the manager and the captain. Usually you've got your English first division teams, and then you've got your three top Scottish clubs, which were Aberdeen, Celtic and Glasgow Rangers. Then we have Euro 88, finally complete. Lovely album. Soccer Superstars from 88, still haven't completed it. One day it will happen. For 89, we've got the One Collection, Football 89. I think this is where Panini started to lose grip to me. Lovely album for Football 88. Of course, this album's also up. Bit of a looking back at this album, this is where Panini started to lose it. Lost the most important part of this album, the second division teams. Why not lose the Scottish teams? Before you start all booing you lot in Scotland, I have got a lot of Panini Scottish albums. So if Panini would have done the Scottish Premier League 89, you know I would have it by now. Now this is the interesting part. They don't all fall down. Let me get organised. I've got plenty. This is gonna run now. We have the Sun Soccer Collection 89-90. This you have to get four tokens in the Sun, and it's just mainly action pictures. The only decent thing which is at the back is you get all the trophies in pure foil. Just like the mirror action shots from the newspaper. Ingenious. Also, the first Merlin album I had. What do you mean that was in 94? No, it wasn't. It was actually Team 90. Now, there's a reason why Team 90 failed miserably. You know, I don't think it's got anything to do with the stickers, because the stickers, and I haven't got many. There you go. A foil A for Aston Villa. I got that free with the Sheet magazine. But how could Merlin really compete when a couple of weeks later that came out, World Cup 90. Again, got all 20 parts, the sticker's still not complete. One day it shall happen. Then we've got your usual Panini Football 90. And of course, World Cup Italia 90. Eventually, thanks to eBay, I completed them. And now it gets even bizarre. The first collection, I think, as per usual, the Sun hit us just before the season starts with Soccer 91. Didn't get around to completing it, still didn't complete it today. Again, just like Team 90 had a problem. Orbis came through with this incredible collection. Footballers from all four divisions, from Manchester United all the way to Rochdale. Now you've got the cover there, Paul Merson, Paul Gascoigne, John Barnes, Richard Shaw's the Crystal Palace player, Pat Nevin, Earl Barton, Brian Robson. Who's the Coventry player? I don't know. Does anyone really care? Then there was, of course, Football 91, which was a total fail. Now, why was that? Another massive collection, Pro Set. And we don't have it all complete. There's a few mistake cards I'm missing. As I said, there are a few autographs from Paul Merson. No, you're not going to really see anything there. Let me just try. There you go. Can you see that? There's Paul Merson's autograph. We've got Perry Groves, Andy Townsend. I think you've got the likes of Brett Angel of Southend. But that was again massive. So Panini 91 was a total fail. Then then, of course, I've done all the videos. Come 92, it went berserk with card collections. First, we had the Pro Set football fixture cards. It did have the three couple of referees for some reason. Only 100 cards. Then Pro Set brought out part one. That's when Panini brought their football cards out. Then it was Merlin's Shooting Stars, where they had the biggest teams and they had the badges on the back. Merlin knew what they were doing. You know, Pro Set seemed to have just bizarrely lost the beauty of what they did in 91, trying to dominate before the Premier League came in. Panini just began adding the Scottish teams. You know, there was also, I remember, yeah, Football 90, it was there, now it was Football 92. Then, I've got a good memory, of course, my first album I actually completed was Euro 92. There was the Junior Panini Cup. Panini stickers with, I think there were 7 stickers. Yeah, I had that, lost it. Football 92, Top Stadium, which I eventually completed a few years ago. And then it was the final album, Football 93, and after that you know the rest. And that takes us on to question 9. Do you still have any of the toys, games or items you held dearly as a child? Well, I've watched a lot of it where if you're a teenager from the age of 13 to 15, you still got it as a child, aren't you? Yes or no? Then you know, I've got my, I've shown you all my football sticker albums. I've still got all my Commodore 64 collection. I've shown you my football figures. I've got bags of football books that I've bought from boot fairs that I've been given. And with the event of eBay, I've bought even bags more, so loving it. And finally, did you ever take a toy into school for show and tell at the end of term? If so, what? The answer is yes, and I can't remember. Honestly, I just can't remember what I bought in. I remember 5 years old when we had the original cable with the Sky Channel. I remember keeping hold of the Premier TV guides. It's a bit of a shove. We've got cable. Now I can't remember. Probably board gaming, maybe. Honestly, cannot remember. I know a lot of other people bought in games. As I said, I used to go around all the board games, and I guarantee I would win or complete them easy, easy, easy. It was only that Screwball Scramble that got me all day. Because he belonged to a young lady, he said he didn't even throw it off the table. But I managed to buy another version on eBay, gave it another go, still couldn't do it. And that ended up worse for wear. Hence what I did there, because the girl was called Misha, and her last name was Ware. Ha! Oh no, I did that. Right, I'm going to call the video quits there. Hey, we're up to 80 minutes, so... what were there? Vloggers... Was it? What? Let me just... 2 vloggers more. I'll leave this video in your description. And anybody on my YouTube wondering where the live streams have gone, I've been hit with a copy strike by YouTube for not fulfilling my obligation of doing the FA Cup final back in May due to problems with, I couldn't stream. I was doing a few things with the FA Vase and the FA Trophy, nothing would work, so I decided to go. Well, I decided to go close to Wembley Stadium, soak in the atmosphere, and then I'll end up watching it in an Indian restaurant where all these Indians had Irish accents. So I'm appealing against this copyright strike. I am looking at other ways of streaming, other streaming sites. Most of them are useless. The game I really want to do is the Sheffield Derby, the Steel Derby. That's the game I'm looking forward to. So I'll get that going. We might be up and running for this season. The copy strike doesn't run out till the 31st of December, so unless I can appeal it and YouTube can see senses why they're giving me this copyright strike. They just gotta look through my channel, how many live streams I've done. But I've noticed YouTube don't see sense. I think this world, no one sees sense where it's. Anyway, video done. Video done, I'll say thank you very much for watching. I love doing them questions, and goodbye for now. Lots of love, and thank you for watching.